family placement is safety of children on children. Okay, it has to be first and foremost. The youth admits to the offenses and takes full responsibility. If you look at that one criteria alone, that is seldom met. Okay, the beginning of the disclosure, the report, the education within the legal system, and coming into the assessment. Okay, just the second one there is seldom met. Okay, they're still trying to hide their offenses. Okay. He or she accepts treatment and understands the reasons for the treatment. Okay, not because, oh, I gotta go to treatment because that's a punishment. Okay, that's not a good attitude to bring to treatment. Okay, because what's going to happen as soon as probation's over or parole is over, they're out the door, whether or not they've completed treatment or not. Okay. That the parents or the other family members, they do not minimize the offenses, which is like making excuses. You know, well, he was sexually abused. That's why he did it. Why aren't you putting that person in jail? But let's come back and focus on what's happening here, not what happened then. You always have to begin with the sexual opinion, not the victimization. The sibling who is the victim is not being coerced into accepting placement within the family. And believe me, that does happen. And one of the primary reasons that that can happen, not among the reasons, I guess I should say, is that family feels so, again, so much shame, so much embarrassment, that what they want to do is what? Hide what is happening to friends, family, and neighbors. And that's understandable, but it's still not acceptable. Understandable, but not acceptable.